Apparently, if you don't have a can opener, you can open a can of food with a spoon. So let's test this out. You gotta hold the spoon like this and just scrape it till it pops. Whoa! And now all I have to do is just keep twisting it. Just like this. Wow! Ow! This is actually painful. Wow, who would have thought? A spoon, a can opener also. So, makes sense. We opened that can. Let's try it again and try to open it a little bit more cleaner and nicer. I'm gonna try it with the glove on. Let's see it. Whoa, look at it. Popped, and then I have to just spin it. This is awesome. Maybe this way will be easier. Wow, this is awesome. Regular spoon. This is so awesome. Boom. And we open that can. This is amazing. That is actually works. And it's a lot easier than I thought. So thumbs up for me. Let's say you're camping out and you forgot a spoon and you have soup or something. Here's the easy way to make a spoon out of a plastic bottle. All you have to do is just follow this line and cut it out like this piece like that. Cut out a piece like this, and now we just need to cut out the piece down this way. Just like that. And then, boom. And here you go, you got a spoon. Now all you need is a lighter. Next we're going to get a lighter and burn it a little bit to get that plastic unsharpened. You can even fold it on this side together, so it's actually look like a spoon. Pretty awesome, huh? Look at that. Here you go, a little spoon. Of course, it's not soup, it's tea, but look at it. Totally working spoon. I like that a lot. So if I'm camping out and I forgot my spoon, but I have plastic bottle, no problem, I can make my own spoon. For this fire starter, I'm going to need 3 or 4 9-volt batteries, 2 wires, alligator clips will work, any kind of wires will work as long as you can hook them up to the 9-volt batteries, and aluminum foil and any kind of pencil. What you want to do is cut it open like that and take the graphite from there. Boom, you see? One piece of a graphite like that. As you can see, I hooked up graphite with the alligator clippers on one side, just like that. Perfect. Now, what I'm gonna do is hook this up like this and like that. Kids, do not try this at home. Boom, they all hooked up like that. This side is plus, this side is minus. Then I'm gonna grab a wire and hook it up on one side on a plus, and the other wire I'm gonna hook it up to the minus like this. Then we're going to get aluminum foil and hook it up to the aluminum foil. If we touch aluminum foil, it will spark up, as you can see. So if you can make it spark like that, that means you can actually start the fire with that. So what I'm gonna do is grab a tissue and put right next to the aluminum foil and just cut it to right here, and we got fire just like that. It's actually a really easy fire starter. Look at it, it's on. That's it. Today I'm going to show you how to make a tripod or suspension for your pot over the fire. Let's check out what I'm talking about. I got here 3 little sticks like that, about 4 or 5 feet tall, and this stick about 8 foot tall, and then we will need a stick like this and some power cord. First of all, what we're going to do is grab these 3 sticks
and tie them together. Go and make a knot on one side first of all. And I'm just gonna rope them around a few times. Then I'm just gonna go under this way and go around this way and pull it through. And I'm just gonna go two times like this. One more time. And then I'm just gonna go to this one. And same thing, like two times around this one. Make it all tight. One more time around here. Boom. And just make a knot. Very simple, nothing special. Just wrap it around a bunch of times and make a knot.
So we got right here three sticks tied up together. So what we're going to do is twist two sticks like this. Boom. And a third one inside like that. Make it wider. Boom. And we got ourselves a really nice tripod. Look at that. It sits very well. That's what we want. Good boys, guys. Good boys. Then we're going to get this 8-foot stick and set it up like this. Also, if you want to make the tripods lower, just spread them out a little bit, no big deal.
This is what it's going to look like. Now let's figure out what we're going to do next. What I'm gonna do next is just cut off this part a little bit smoother. Look at Yuga, he likes the wood chips flakes. He's like, oh, what is that? What is that? Is this a dirt? Is that dirt? You better not jump though. He's like, whoa, what is this falling? Okay, then after we're done that, all we have to do is just, hey, get down. I have a sharp knife over here. What are you doing? So next, we're just going to make a little hole right here. Stop barking, Luke. So just like that, drill a little hole in there. You'll find out why in a minute. Next, we will need to make notches down here. We got ourselves a hook on this side, so I'm gonna hold it like this, and we need to make a notch. Go away, Hugo, this is sharp. We don't need to get injured over here. So I'm just gonna hold the knife at the angle like this and drive it in, then take it out, put it on this side, probably have to do it with my left hand, and drive it in. And then we're going to take it out and scrape it on this side. Takes a little bit of practice. Just gotta be patient and careful. Boom, and we got ourselves a notch right here. Not the best one that I did, so next one probably will be even better. So once again, same thing. I'm gonna hold this stick, go like that at the angle. Then probably have to do it with left hand again. This one turned out to be the best one. There is a little bit of practice to figure it out how to do it the best way.
Next is very simple step. Get your pot, put it over your hook right here. This is pretty small pot. And then right here you can stick it like this. Hey guys, you cannot see it. The audience cannot see it. Get on this side, look. Get on this side, come on. Now Hugo been good. So this is it, if you, guys, they cannot see the how it works. You blocking the view. Come on, guys. Get in the back this way. Get right here. There you go. Luke, get on this side. Come on, I'll give you some space. Why are you so stubborn? Get over here. Get over here. Ah, you just want to snuggle. That's it. Man, these dogs are like babies. There you go, guys. Let me show you again. You got yourself this hook now.
and put it your pot. This is just a small teapot, and then you can hook it, boom, like this. And right here you're going to have a fire, of course. Of course, you probably need to move your tripod a little bit, so that way your tripod not in the fire, like this or something like that. Boom, you got yourself fire down here. Your pot is warm, and you boil your water, and then you don't want to make coffee just yet. So what you can do is put it on a, you gotta get out of here. You can put it on a higher knob, even higher knob right here. So that way the water does not boil as much, but slowly simmer or just stays warm. But if you really want to get it closer to the fire, you put it down this way. I love this system. This is so amazing. I never seen anything like that. And I tried this for the first time, and it was actually very simple to make. Wow, this is a great idea. Let me just show you guys close up. Boom, three legs right here, a giant stick, and a pot right here. And you see, it does not fall off. Hugo kind of knock it off and shaking it around, and it stays there pretty good. Look at that. He might knock it off if he's gonna keep pushing it, but as you can see, he really moving it hard, and it's not falling off. Good boy, Hugo. You really did put it to the test. And today I'm gonna show you another zombie apocalypse survivor tip. We're gonna be hacking 823 energizer battery, so let's get to it. This is pretty famous hack, but all you need is 823 energizer battery. You see 823, it costs around $5, and pliers. Open this battery just on the line over here, you see, just grab it and peel it away. As you can see, it's nothing too hard, just grab it and peel it off. And check this out, we're gonna open our, take that paper out and keep opening it, and guess what we're gonna get. Look, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cell batteries. A lot smaller batteries, but sometimes if you need a thermometer, you know, to check somebody's temperature, or like small devices, and you can power up a bunch of small other devices. But if you have a bunch of cell batteries like that, you can stack them up and get some electric tape and wrap them around. Like put them like that next to each other. And yeah, if you want a bigger battery, you just continue stacking them and just make sure they are like connecting to each other, you know. And when you're done, you can just cut it. So now you got this small battery bag. Make one battery out of many cell batteries, or you can just, if you need a bunch of small cell batteries, you can just open it like I did it at first and get a bunch of little ones. And as always, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Peace out.